welcome to a new session of Pioneers Talk. Today we have Hans-Jörg Krassnig with us. So welcome, Hans-Jörg.
Hello, Tom. Thank you very much for the invitation.
You're welcome. So the reason we have Hans-Jörg with us is to discuss electric steelmaking, and more specifically, the role of electric steelmaking in the transition to green steel. And incidentally, Hans-Jörg, that's my first question to you. So what role will electric steelmaking play with green steel happening?
Yeah, yes, indeed. The electric arc furnace will play a major role in the green steel production. The transformation of existing integrated steel plants to electric arc furnace-based melt shops will pick up speed quickly. Mm-hmm. So we expect a share of blast furnace-based production to change from 70% to 70% based on scrap and DI steel production. Mm-hmm.
So what kind of time frame are you looking at for this major shift?
We assume at least 3 decades.
Okay.
For this transition. Yeah, and this transition from liquid hot metal production based on carbon intensive blast furnace technology towards hydrogen reduced DI requires an additional process step to melt this DI to liquid crude steel. Mm-hmm. And this is exactly the main job of the electric arc furnace, to melt various raw materials like scrap, cold DI or hot DI in a very efficient manner with close to minimum zero carbon emissions. Like our ultimate electric arc furnace with the ultimate raw material flexibility, or the quantum electric arc furnace with 100% scrap preheating by utilizing the sensible heat of the off-gas. So at the end of at the final stage of green steel, the CO2 reduction potential is more than 90% by using crafted scrap, hydrogen reduced DRI, renewable powered EFs. So the future is electric.
Mm-hmm. And part of this electric future is, of course, the raw materials, which will change with electric steelmaking on the rise. You mentioned crafted scrap as one of these raw materials. What is crafted scrap? From what I've heard, Primetals Technologies define it as it's well-sorted scrap. Mm-hmm. It's also processed to some degree. Is that correct?
Yes, but scrap is a major factor in the circular economy to achieve sustainable steel production. And crafted scrap, as you said, is all about analyzing, screening and cleaning of scrap, and also digitalization of the entire route from scrapyard to the finished product.
Mm-hmm. Thank you very much for this explanation. We may do a Pioneers Talk session specifically on crafted scrap in the future, because I think raising the percentage of scrap used in steel production will be an important factor.
Absolutely.
But before we get to that, we go back to electric steel making and to one of your recent projects that you just started effectively. It's for Salzgitter, a German steel producer. And I believe they decided to choose an ultimate furnace. But what prompted them to want to do this project with you, Hans-Jörg?
Well, the transformation of an existing integrated steel plant with a long tradition such as Salzgitter's requires significant changes to the production processes and to the plant infrastructure. And to master these challenges, additionally to excellent technologies and proven references, there's a comprehensive knowledge about process engineering, environmental technology, automation, digitalization, logistics, erection and project management required. And this all-round expertise is exactly the strength of Primetals and was recognized by Salzgitter.
It feels like you're very proud of this project. It's much more than just the electric arc furnace. And you said it's a complete package. Can you tell me some details of supporting technologies mm-hmm. that were part of this package?
Yes, there's a bunch of smart products included, like our Melt Expert. This is our electrode control system, which ensures perfect condition in each project step and ensures lowest consumption figures. The LOMAS, our continuous off-gas measurement system, which ensures a perfect control of the burner system in each process step. The Alex, our condition monitoring system, which gives intelligent recommendations to avoid unplanned downtimes and to ensure consistently high product quality. The LiquiRob system is included, our robot system for automatic sampling and temperature measurement. What else? Maybe it's worth to mention that we will install the largest waste heat recovery system ever installed in an electric steelmaking plant. Furthermore, the electric arc furnace will come with the most advanced de-dusting system and water treatment plant, fulfilling the most stringent environmental regulations.
I mean, that is a large package.
Yes,
you mentioned the LiquiRob mm-hmm. technology. It's a robotic solution, hence the name mm-hmm. LiquiRob. Will this solution increase operational safety on mm-hmm. the plant? Where do you see this going?
Yes, with the LiquiRob, we are fulfilling our vision of zero man on the floor, automatic control of all processes, remote control of all equipments.
Okay.
And we are ready for that vision.
Uh-huh. This project involves the ultimate furnace. Mm-hmm. Is that the furnace you expect most producers to look for, mm-hmm. or is it more region dependent? So in other words, mm-hmm. some producers would really like to go for the ultimate furnace, others on different furnace types because of the circumstances mm-hmm. They're dealing with?
Yes, good question. For top performers like Salzgitter in Europe or in other parts of the world, the ultimate electric arc furnace is the first choice. With the ultimate electric arc furnace, the customer has the greatest flexibility in the raw material usage, ensuring minimum conversion costs. In Asia, for example, we see an increased availability of scrap, so the quantum electric arc furnace with the preheating technology is the first choice. With the quantum, we can ensure a preheating of the scrap by utilizing the sensibility of the off-gas. We can achieve consumption figures less than 300 kilowatt hours per ton, which is remarkable. And also in combination with the ESP plant, we can provide the smallest energy footprint from scrap to finished steel coil, unbeatably low.
That sounds great. And we've already done an episode of Pioneer's Talk on ESP, which mm-hmm. is short for endless strip production. And so we would want to tell our audience that if you're interested mm-hmm. in endless strip production, please watch the video that we're going to link in our description. But don't go there quite yet, because we're not done here with Hans-Jörg, okay? But please check it out. Mm-hmm. So Hans-Jörg, this combination that you just outlined of the ultimate, rather the quantum furnace in mm-hmm. this case, right? The scrap-based furnace. The one with the scrap preheating, to be mm-hmm. really precise, and electric endless steel production. Mm-hmm. This combination has been tried and tested. Mm-hmm. Primetals Technologies actually built plants using this combination. Mm-hmm. Where did the company do this?
Yeah, we have installed plants, a combination of the quantum and ESP plant in China, which is the most competitive steel producer in Asia when it comes to flat steel production. We have installed quantum electric arc furnaces in combination with long casters and in flat production in Mexico. And the steel producer are one of the most competitive steel producers in the world. Yeah?
Mm-hmm. One issue I hear occasionally mentioned in relationship to electric arc furnaces mm-hmm. is power consumption and mm-hmm. the consequences of them being so power hungry. Okay. So first of all, what you don't want in a city with a steel producer present is whenever they turn on their EF, the lights go out. Yeah. Okay, so that you don't want. Also, you don't want the lights to flicker because there's weird interaction with the electrical grid. Are there any solutions available to fix this issue?
Yeah, the flicker you know from the movies will not happen anymore.
All right.
But you're right, the availability of the quantity and quality of the electrical energy is a decisive factor for low CO2 steelmaking. Mm-hmm. So the availability of renewable energy is a decisive factor. But not only for steelmaking, but also for electrified processes in general. So, and there's a lot going on out there. And the investment in the infrastructure are massive. And in Europe, the expansion of the grid is already happening. Yeah? And what's important from the steelmaking point of view is to ensure a high quality of the electric power grid. And with our active power feeder, we can ensure a high quality of the power grid, like minimum flicker level. With the active power feeder, we can control the power from the grid to the electric arc furnace and back.
Am I correct in assuming that the active power feeder is, in a way, the power supply that takes the energy from the electrical grid, passes it on to the furnace, but more than just the supply, also some technology added on top of it?
It actively controls the power to the electric arc furnace and back to the grid actively, and also in combination with our melt expert.
Okay.
This is a crucial part, and this is unique, this configuration to Primetals. And with the active power feeder, we can precisely control the arc length. Yeah? We can control the arc, and we can maintain a consistent power level into the electric arc furnace, regardless of the quality of the network.
So that means you get a very, very stable arc and a very consistent, stable process, even if the grid's pretty bad.
Absolutely. Totally right.
Okay. Wow. This sounds great. Hey, let's move on to the next question. So we've already discussed a couple of developments that you expect. Is there any trends in your field that excites you?
The production of high-quality steel grades will be a key in the future based on the electric arc furnace route. We already introduced in our secondary metallurgy new approaches for the production of high-advanced steel grades like automotive steel grades. At Chulakoglu, for example, we installed a VOD plant with a heat size of 300 tons, which is a world record in stainless steel making. And at the same plant, we produce steel grades with less than 5 ppm parts per million carbon levels after decarbonization, which marks another world record. So Tom, I can guarantee that we will carry on setting benchmarks and shaping the future of steelmaking.
I'll take your word for it, Hans-Jörg. I look forward to your next couple of records, okay? But really, you know, every time I talk to you about electric steelmaking, I sense your real excitement about the furnace at the core, I think, right? Can you just tell me why this technology has such a significance to you?
Well, standing in front of an electric arc furnace leaves no one cold. The electric arc furnace with its particular sound is the beating heart of the steel plant.
So a lot of rumbling.
And vibrations.
And vibrations. Good vibrations, I hope.
Yeah. Only good vibrations.
Yeah.
And temperatures above 8,000 centigrades, heat sizes of more than 300 tons, huge amount of energies and forces bundled in one unit. Mechanical parts, but also electrical parts surviving in the harshest environment impresses me the most. And not to forget, the electric arc furnace is the most efficient recycling machine in the world.
Wow, okay. The most efficient recycling machine in the world.
In my opinion, yes.
Yeah, I'm sure it is. Hans-Jörg, I think this is a great note to end this conversation on. So thank you very much for being here today with us at Pioneers Talk. Thank you for watching this episode. We've already invited you to watch the ESP episode as well. So please go ahead now, and we will see you very shortly.